Hey, everybody, it's the coach. Welcome to the special Saturday edition of the NFL on EA Sports. We're just about set to get started, and this ought to be a good one between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Tennessee Titans. With that, let's get you up to Nashville and Nissan Stadium for the call. We welcome in our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with Jameis Winston and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. It'll be Jameis Winston leading this unit, the fourth-year quarterback from Florida State.
And there's little doubt that he's looking for a big-time bounce-back season in 2018. Everyone expected a big year in 2017, but the team won just three times in his 13 starts. Some of that, you got to put on their defense. They struggled, but there are too many inopportune turnovers that continue to plague him.
On first and 10, Winston. And his first look is incomplete. The intended receiver that time, Adam Humphries. And that'll bring up second down. And a peek now at the offense for Tampa Bay.
And DeSean Jackson is the guy that your eyes naturally gravitate towards because he's a big play waiting to happen. In his career, usually averages about 20 yards a catch. Last season in 2017, closer to 13 yards per catch. Look for him to be recommitted to getting back downfield and catching the long ball.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Ready, blue, ready.
A first carry now for the rookie from SC. It's Ronald Jones. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Three and out, a real danger here on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 12. From the shotgun, it's Winston. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. Brian Arakpo, he's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they left little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Here's Jackson. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. They'll be led out by their fourth-year quarterback from Oregon, Marcus Mariota.
The numbers in 2017, not what anyone expected. 13 touchdowns, but 15 interceptions, although he did lead the Titans to the playoffs for the first time in a decade, and then led them to a huge upset victory in Kansas City in the wild card round. Go, go.
Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10, right at the 30. Now a first carry for Derrick Henry. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in the old days were often outside linebackers, and they just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running backs quicker than ever before.
Second down throw for Mariota. And this complete to Henry over the middle. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. He'll get a couple yards on that one. And that's going to lead to a third and 11. And now we get a peek at the Titan offense.
The Titans wanted a little bit more out of the number 5 pick in the draft in 2017, and that is Corey Davis. And I expect that they'll get it moving forward. Beset by hamstring injuries in preseason last year, it was slow going in the beginning, but he really started to come on as the season concluded. In fact, in the postseason, 9 catches, 98 yards, with 2 touchdowns in 2 games. I expect that he'll be the number 1 receiver in 2018 and beyond.
And this one is incomplete.
Trust me, Brandon, I'm not about to try and take your job. I can't do what you do. But that wasn't just 3 and out. That felt like 3 and backwards.
That's exactly what it was. You can have my job whenever you want it. The drive that you're looking for, though, probably going forward, bad start to the ball game.
Yeah, not the way to get things going.
On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. A 47-yard punt, maybe a couple on the return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 23. Winston now to throw on first down. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. The starting defense for the Titans.
Let's say hello to Derek Morgan, who came into the league as a first-round pick as a defensive end and has converted himself into a really nice outside linebacker. Beats opposing blockers with quickness and strength and is a real feature player for his Tennessee Titans.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On second down, it's Jones. And he'll get this one up to the 26. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with third and still 7 yards to go.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
On third down, Winston. And Winston lost the football. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Mm-hmm. Here's Brian Anger now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And before the punt, time is going to run out on this first quarter. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. It's a 45-yard punt, just a 1-yard return, and it'll be Titan football. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10, right at the 30. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Stop made there by Gerald McCoy. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is
a not just a big man,
big,
a huge man.
Big, big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be able to chop that big tree and put him on the ground?
I know back when you played, it took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Well,
the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Quan Alexander. Not dropping into coverage, he comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Well, there was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving them exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Mariota will need a big play after the sack as the Titans come up third and long. Working out of the gun, Mariota. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, he bounced up after taking a sack and took a shot downfield. I think a lot of us thought maybe he'd run draw in that situation instead. Tried to get all back in one play.
Yeah, third and long, thought he needed the deep pass, couldn't connect it.
Maybe he was hoping for a penalty downfield to give him the yardage they needed.
He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. This is taken around the 12. That one in the books as a 64-yard punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 22. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucs may have moved.
False start, offense.
And that'll set them back 5.
Still first down.
A full start backs him up 5, first and 15. Jameis to throw it. He's got the hookup here to DeSean Jackson. It's a 14-yard pickup, but it'll still be second down.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
They'll pitch it out to Jones. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. 2 minutes remain in a scoreless first half. Back to Tennessee after this. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll check in with our Jonathan Coachman. He'll have highlights and analysis of the first half, and our highlights will likely be on the defensive side of the football here. Scoreless game.
Let's go now.
A nickel set shown by the Titans on third down.
Thinking pass. To throw, Winston. This is caught by Jackson. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you could actually be pushed back before the first down. It's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the first down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
Jameis now on first down. Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Play fake. Winston. Room here to run. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Play action now, Winston. Wide open receiver complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Winston in the offense with a first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. First down, Winston. It's caught, Humphreys. And he's brought down. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. First time into the red zone for the Buccaneers. They come up first and 10 at the 16.
Blue 8.
From the red zone now, Winston. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Bucs are able to strike for six.
That's one of those touchdown tosses where if it's an inch to the right or left, it's not a touchdown. He had to put it right on the money.
Yeah, and how did he do that? Everything around him, everything swirling, all the coverage downfield. Somehow he spotted the opening and put it right there.
Here's Chandler Catanzaro for the extra point. Extra point up and good by Catanzaro. And that makes the score 7-0. So that drive in total 8 plays. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. Adoree Jackson on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field.
And this is their third drive. Maybe the focus right now not so much on points, but getting their first down.
And when you start off a game, you don't even think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a second drive, no first down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play calling do I have to do to get us in a spot to pick that first one up?
They begin with Henry. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense, as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. Mariota now on second down. Rishard Matthews here on the catch. And on third and inches, we're going to get a whistle and a timeout, as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout, and now we're set to get going. Oh, it's a nickel set here defensively on third and inches.
Still want to be prepared for a pass.
From the gun, Mariota. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
And what did we talk with them about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0 for 3 on third down. If that continues, they'll have little chance of winning this one.
Here's Brett Kern now, as he's on to punt for Tennessee. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback.
Where's that up?
They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one's been a hard-fought battle to this point. 7-0 is the score.